As missionaries of the precious blood, we commit ourselves to the service of God and the Church under the sign of the blood of Christ. Following in the footsteps of St. Gaspar and sensitive to the signs of the times, we are bound together by the bond of charity and engaged in the ministry of the Word, bringing that word of truth and renewal to a world so much in need of God's redeeming and liberating love. Our lay associates embrace this as well, as we see in the recent Companion's Vision statement, step up, stand out, speak clearly. Or in the words of one of my favorite poets, Mary Oliver, pay attention, be astonished, tell others. Speak out, tell others. About what? About the fact that God loved the world so much that Jesus happened. And that love could not be contained or measured or rationed out or applied discriminately. The precious blood of Jesus is a powerful reminder that God still loves the world, the whole world, and calls us into covenant time and again, no exceptions, no matter what. God wants to save us all. Jubilarians are hopefully examples of people who have witnessed to that love over a long period of time. A period of time that has seen change after change after change in the world, the Church, in their ministries, and in our bodies. But what didn't change was the power and the call of the precious blood, the gift of God's love, by which we are redeemed and sanctified, brought near and made one. So if you would, for a few minutes, go back with me a few years to 1940. World War II was raging. That was the year that Auschwitz concentration camp opened. The precious blood of Jesus was still being shed, but God still called us to covenant and loved us. So the first McDonald's opened in San Bernardino. Good news. Cincinnati won the World Series, 4-3 over Detroit. And Father Leonard Kostka was ordained a priest. 1950, the Korean War began. The blood of Jesus continued to be shed, but God still called us to covenant. And God still loved us. So, thanks be to God, that was the year that the Peanuts comic strip started. And Father Al Herber was ordained a priest. Brother Gregory Frantz and Brother Joseph Mary Hrezo were incorporated. 1955, Rosa Parks was arrested in Montgomery, which led to the Montgomery bus boycott. That was the year the first military advisors and the first financial aid was sent to Vietnam. The United States intervened for the first time in Iran. And so the precious blood of Jesus was still being shed. But God still called us to covenant and loved us. And so, Disneyland opened. And the polio vaccine was declared safe and began to be used. But more important, Father Ronald Schimmel was ordained and Brother Jerome Schulte was incorporated. 1965, Martin Luther King and 2,600 others were arrested during voting rights demonstrations, and the first U.S. combat troops went to Vietnam. And so the precious blood of Jesus continued to be shed, and still God called us to covenant, and God loved us. And so Vatican II ended with great promise, and the American province gave birth to triplets. And Father Pat Patterson and Father Kenneth Schroeder were ordained. 1975, Jimmy Hoffa disappeared. Still haven't found him. The Vietnam War ended on April 30th, but not the pain, neither there nor here. And so the blood of Jesus continued to be shed, but God still called us to covenant and loved us. And so thanks be to God, Wheel of Fortune debuted on TV. An apple was founded. Father Ron Will and Father Robert Schreiber and myself, Father Richard Bayuk, were ordained, and Brother Thomas Bohman was incorporated. Tom, you're the only other 40th person here today. I'm not sure if you're aware that that's also the summer that the movie Jaws premiered. I don't want to make a connection there. 1990, the Gulf War began. So the blood of Jesus was still being shed, but God still called us to covenant and loved us. So Nelson Mandela was released from prison after 28 years. East and West Germany were reunited. Companions movement began with the very first being formally welcomed. And most important of all, or second most important of all, Cincinnati again won the World Series, 4-0 over Oakland. And Father Jeff Finley and Father Ken Schnipke, Father Scott Kramer, and Father Daniel Torson were ordained. Which brings us to this day, this feast. Eucharist, past, present, and future all together. War, poverty, racism, oppression, violence still exist. The blood of Christ is still shed, but God still calls us to covenant. And in the words of today's post-communion prayer, we are all called through the sharing in the one chalice of the blood of Jesus to embrace God's work of justice and peace. About 4 years ago, when my father was still living independently in his own home and was still able to drive and take care of his own business, I was spending some time visiting him, and I asked him one morning, when he got home, how his trip to the bank had gone. And Dad had a pretty good sense of humor, and with kind of a twinkle in his eye, he said, you know, it's really pretty difficult to get good customer service anymore. For example, I asked Nancy, the teller at the bank, if she could check my balance. So she leaned over and pushed me. Kinds of balance. We need to check our balance sometimes. Both kinds. And we can lose our balance. Both kinds. The bond of charity means that we can lean on one another when we lose those balances. After his grandfather's death, the poet Donald Hall went into his grandfather's attic. He found a whole bunch of boxes. And one of the boxes, when he opened it, was filled with Nothing but little, tiny, short pieces of string. And on the cover of the box, his grandfather had written in his own handwriting, "String too short to be saved." But he saved it. He had saved all that string that was too short to be saved. If you have ever felt like you were a string too short to be saved, you can begin to come to know what it means to be loved and accepted by God in Jesus Christ, to be brought near by the blood of Christ. This can be true for a religious community as well. God loves the missionaries of the Precious Blood and all its members and companions, volunteers, friends, staff. And God's going to save all of us in a great big attic. Nothing is ever lost to God. Nothing. No one. And I am certain that all of us in our various ministries know this to be true. As we have reached out, as we continue to reach out to those on the margins, to those that the world is tempted to discard. Strings too short to be saved, according to some, but not to God, and not to us. God so loved the world that it broke God's heart. So God squeezed God's self into a tiny human body that was eventually broken and bled for us. A body that never lost its balance, not even when lifted up high. Empty, but not empty. Broken, but not broke. It's good to check our balance from time to time, both kinds, right? Knowing that we too can be emptied, but not empty, broken, but not broke. And so may this body gathered here today also never lose its balance as we step out, stand up, speak clearly, as we pay attention and be astonished and tell others. As we come together on this day dedicated to the Precious Blood, united with Jesus and one another, in this profound act of love, this profound act of being saved, and as I reflect on the many years of service represented by those of us Jubilarians gathered here, it's over 700 years, by the way. I recall the words of the poet Mary Oliver. Sometimes I need only to stand wherever I am to be blessed.